Hi guys, Chuff here again, and this is long in the making. I haven't done one of these for a while on the desk updates. So what I've got on the desk at the moment, I've got this little guy. It's the character model from the Bad Ab Wars for the Salamanders. I have done an unboxing. I have basically taken off the icons and stuff on here, which had Gene Stealers fighting some Terminators. I've taken that off, smoothed it off, green putted it, sanded it back, so that's now all sorted. Banner pole I've not put on this guy because it has G-Stealers stuff on it. Have taken the top part off, and I've got a few other things to do which you'll see in other updates and things like that. I have also magnetized the arms, which means that I can then change it for any other arms from Forge World, which is pretty cool. I've also magnetized the lower part of these arms. This is the Dreadfire weaponry. That's that guy. And I bought the Contemptor Dreadnought multi-melters because they actually fit in on that shoulder and obviously onto that guy. So if I do the same with this side, there's it. Click, click, turn it a little bit. So there we go. It looks quite nice. I really like that system of using these shoulders, and it means that I can use the Contemptor weapons on these, because I prefer the Contemptor auto cannons and things like that, so I can actually stick those on. So I might do that, and that's the head separately ready for me to paint. What I've also got to paint at the moment is this little guy, which some people like, some people don't. It's the Navigator, the special event model that was released at the Horus Heresy Weekender. I picked up two of these, and this is the first one that I've got to paint. So that's for my army, nice and purple, which my wife loves that colour. So, what else have I been using? I've started using these new pigments from a company called Broken Toad. Let me show you. There we go. So this is Rust. They've got 20 of these in their range. They're really big pots, 30 milliliters in each, which is a lot for pigments these days. Let me take him out of the way. He's getting in the way a bit. They just brought out a new one, which I bought, which is this. Perished Earth, which is more of a kind of a brown tone to it. One thing I found with these pigments is they're very, very, very fine, so they're great for mixing, they're great for basically putting on your minis and stuff. The way that they work, it's almost a bit like makeup in some ways. It's that fine, which is really good. I have found things like MIG pigments are a little bit more coarse. One other thing that they've released today, which I suggest you guys go out and have a look at, is Broken Toad's miniature series Kalinske Sable brushes. Now, I'll be honest, I only got this yesterday. I spoke to the owner, I knew the range was coming out. I bought this with my own money and this new pigment because I really do like them. And I have been using, I have been using the old staple Series 7 from Winsor & Newton. Both these are size 2, and they both have a very nice snap. One thing I've found with my Series 7 only recently is starting to fork a little bit, and considering I've only been using it for about 4 months, that's not so good. And the one on the right from Broken Toad is half the price. It's the same ferrule or same hairs, and the ferrule itself, or the metal bit here, has no join that you get in the low end brushes. It's a high end brush, feels quite nice. I have used it on a couple of scratches and things that I've done on an apothecary I've finished, which I'll do in another video. I'm going to give this brush a good workout on my dreadnought. So that gives me a chance to be able to comment a little bit better. But I'm really excited by these brushes. I think they'll be really good, especially at the price. I mean, this is half the price of my Winsor & Newton. And they're both the same bristles. The snap in both is pretty much the same. Right, in fact, let's do that on camera. I actually wet. I'm a brush licker. See if I can get this in focus for you guys. There we go. So you can see the bristles, they look all the same. Both size 2, the broken toed one's a little bit smaller, which is fine. And you can see the snap. But that might be because it's new. You can see that already my Winsor & Newton's falling apart. But this is maybe due to age. We'll have to see. So I'm going to give it a good bash. Get back to you guys. Make sure you know what's going on with it. I do suggest checking them out. I think they're a value for money considering the price people pay for like army painter brushes, for GW brushes, things like this. It's worth investing in quality things. You will actually see quality results, and it makes life a lot easier. So I suggest check that out and probably pick up a couple of sets for you guys. I do suggest it. What else have I got going on? I have finished an apothecary and a few other bits and pieces which I will be showing. Let me show you something on the screen, at least make it more interesting for you. Sorry, this is a bit of a ramble video as much as anything. So yeah, I have 14 Catifractai Terminators left to paint, build and paint. I've still got 15 boarding marines to do. I've got a Spartan now. With the Horus Heresy Weekender, I'm looking forward to the Fire Drake Terminators. I want 10 of them. And also Vulcan himself, I want to get 2 of those. One to paint and one to paint better than the first, so you know you can learn the model from the first one. So that's what I'm hoping to do. There's quite a lot of bits and pieces going on, some gaming to go on as well, so we shall see what goes on. I hope you enjoyed this bit of a ramble really for me, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Take care, guys.